Hello guys, this is Dr. Palani Pramanikam. In this video, we're going to talk about fatty liver. While I was in India, for every CT scan and ultrasound that I saw for my friends and relatives, everybody had this fatty liver on the report for imaging that was done for some other reason. One of my family members was actually asking me, Daypal, do you know any good doctor in US who treats fatty liver? I'm the doctor. So at the end of the video, you will know what is fatty liver, what are the symptoms, why is it very important, and more importantly, how do you find out whether you have fatty liver or not? Let's dive deep into it. So there are two reasons for excess fat in the liver. Number one, alcohol can cause fat in the liver. Number two, if you are fat overall, the excess fat gets deposited in the liver. Thankfully, drinking alcohol has been considered as a taboo in Indian culture, especially when I grew up, though this is changing now. My friend Saravana Kumar is like, I don't drink alcohol daily, da. I drink alcohol only when I smoke. And I smoke only when I get bored, and I'm getting bored daily. I'm assuming that all my YouTube family members will not drink alcohol, so this might not be applicable to you. But if you do, please subscribe to my friend Saravana Kumar channel. It says save water, drink beer. So we're going to talk about non-alcoholic fatty liver in this video. So when your body has more calories than needed, the extra energy gets converted into fat and gets stored in other parts of the body where it is not supposed to. It is exactly similar to my wife saying in the hospital pager inga vekkadinga ethana thara solradhu appdi solli thooki potta. For example, if your body needs only 2000 calories but you're taking 2500 calories, the extra 500 calories first goes to your belly fat and then goes to your liver, causing fatty liver. The beauty is that the damage caused by the gulab jamun is almost equal to the damage caused by the alcohol that many people are not knowing. Non-alcoholic fatty liver sounds like we didn't do anything wrong. If we go to the temple, if we eat the prasad, God will remove the fat. Actually, the tamarind rice and the sakkara pongal can aggravate the existing fat in the fatty liver. Sometimes there will be so much fat in the liver that God himself will say, hey, this is too much fat to remove, da. Please go to the next temple. So what will happen when fat gets deposited in the liver? Stage 1, the liver gets big. We call it as fatty liver. Number 2, the cells become red and angry. It's inflamed. Stage 2, called NASH. Stage 3 is more and more fat gets accumulated. There is scar tissue formation called fibrosis. And then stage 4 is there are so much scar tissue that liver will not work at all. Complete shutdown. We call that as cirrhosis stage 4. So to understand this, think me as an example after marriage. Initially, when she argued, I got angry. Stage 1. She argued more. I got very angry. Stage 2. And then she argued more again. I got very, very angry. Stage 3. And finally, stage 4. I know that nothing can be done. I completely shut down. Cirrhosis. So why is it important to know about all these stages? Because there will be no symptoms at all. You might be in stage 2, stage 3, but you will be running around without any complaints at all. The only time that you will have any symptom is stage 4, where your liver is completely shut down, where people actually vomit blood and come to the hospital. When patients present with stage 4 liver disease with vomiting blood, unfortunately, there is nothing that we could do or no medications can be given except for liver transplantation by taking your old liver out and giving you a new liver, and that is extremely serious, and that is why we need to monitor our liver properly so that we don't end up in that stage. So when heroes in the movies vomit blood after love failure, people think that it is blood cancer. It is not blood cancer. It is liver failure. He not only needs a new lover, he also needs a new liver. So now we know what are the complications of a fatty liver. The $1 million question is, how do we know whether we have fatty liver or not? You don't need any $1 million workup. No need of ultrasound, no need of CT scan, no need of MRI. Just a simple blood test will do the deal. So if you are a member of Dr. Pal's YouTube family, you must have known these numbers by heart, that if your waist circumference is more than 90 centimeters in men and more than 80 centimeters in women, I beg you to get this blood work of 5 different variables at least once. So this blood test will tell us how your liver is working. We need 5 things: AST, ALT, platelet count, albumin, and your glucose levels. Yes, AST and ALT are your liver enzymes. You might have to pay GST to get the blood work done. So once you have these 5 numbers, you're going to jot it down in an equation called NAFLD score, non-alcoholic fatty liver score. This will tell us an idea about how much fat is deposited in the liver and what stage you are in this fatty liver progression. So let's see what the Saravana Kumar numbers are. He is 38 years old. His BMI is 25. And impaired fasting glucose is, if your fasting glucose level is more than 100, then you have some kind of impaired glucose levels. levels. So his fasting blood glucose level was like 110. So we're going to check yes. His AST, his upper limit of normal, it is not even that high. It's only 41. His ALT is upper limit of normal again, 35. His platelet count is 150. And his albumin is again within normal limits, but on the lower level, 3.5. So if you calculate the score, it comes around 0.11, which comes around to be indeterminate score. If you go down and look at the evidence, the fibrosis severity is F0 is no fibrosis, F4 is cirrhosis, so indeterminate is somewhere between F2 to F3. So he has some kind of scar tissue in the liver, he needs to take care of it right away. If not, this will progress to cirrhosis, requiring liver transplantation in the next 8 to 10 years, high likelihood. So in the worst case scenario, you do the blood work, you put your numbers in this score, and then you are diagnosed with fatty liver. Nothing to be concerned about, because the golden treatment of weight loss completely works for this disease. Your fat in your liver will completely disappear if you can lose 10% of your body weight every 6 months. So liver is like our mummy. She's so loyal to us. They will never let us go. You know that mummy always returns, but if tummy returns, mummy will not return. Why I'm stressing this point so much is, except for weight loss, there is no other treatment for this fatty liver. If you're drinking alcohol, stop drinking that. All the other medications like vitamin E, UDCA, the liver 52, all these will not improve your liver enzymes a lot based on research studies. Don't spend your money on all these medications. Spend money on adopting a healthy lifestyle. Maybe you can buy a treadmill, even if you are planning to hang your clothes on. The only two things that will help in weight loss is Mediterranean diet and time-restricted feeding in terms of fatty liver. Mediterranean diet, we'll talk more about it in future videos. When I said this to my friend Saravana Kumar, I need to go to Mediterranean Sea to dieting. That is so expensive. How about Marina Beach? So please do me a huge favor. If you meet the criteria for waist circumference, please get a blood work that will check AST, ALT, platelet, albumin, and glucose levels. Once you get these five numbers, jot those numbers in the score that has been given in the description and write down your stage of fatty liver if you have one in the description. So there is another issue that we don't have time to cover in this video. It's called lean fatty liver, where fatty liver can happen in lean patients as well, especially with Indian ancestry. If you have other factors like family history of diabetes and everything. So please talk to your doctor to see if you are lean, should you have to check this blood work as well. So if you or your relatives have been diagnosed with fatty liver on an ultrasound or a CT scan that was done for some other reason, do not panic. That is not the end of the world. You need to find these numbers to see which stage are you in. And I can guarantee you that if you can lose 10% of your weight every 6 months, I can guarantee you that liver will come back to normal. So belly fat can lead to liver failure eventually. That's why I keep saying that your abs are absolutely important. If you feel like you got something positive out of this discussion, please consider donating to our Aishwaryam Trust, which is a non-profit organization we run in Madurai for hospice patients who have exhausted all the medical options and towards the end of their life, where they don't have any financial support as well. You can support them. The link is in the description. Remember, one belly at a time, it is absolutely important. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.